2 weeks. I don't even want to pretend, I'm not going to cap. But then I saw her at an event, at a venue much like this one, and I just didn't feel anything. And I was like, fuck yeah, thank God, right? So this one's called That I Don't Care. Can you also write a song though?
I spend days thinking about the ways that I could touch your face. The things I'd say, put your hand on the way to our favorite place. I realize I'm in the moments we've been there before. No way, but I think I miss the way that I felt focused. So focused on you, then I see you in the flesh. It's been nothing but something stopping there, something's in place. I don't think it's you that I'm. Position is draining my head. Full flesh, thought you were the problem, but I blame you instead. I made a big deal about a version of you that I knew was real. So when you're in the flesh, it's not quite what I would expect.
My medicine.
incredible students in Wales right now. We're doing student encampments, and it's beautiful. And there's local encampments to you as well. Student ones, people who are fighting back. It's free Palestine, man. It's a wonderful time. But yeah, if you ever have time to visit a local encampment, you don't have to stay, but 1 or 2 hours, help, anything you can do, please do. This song's called Decay, and it's about how much I hate this fucking encampment.
Don't stop, make it pop, DJ, blow my speakers up tonight. I'm a A plus size badass bitch.
I call it bi, shy, and ready to cry.
I call it try my best to be the kind of person that I needed when I was younger.
I call it a wonderfully queer woman in love with her life.
I call it non-binary and autistic.
I call it a bisexual who speaks up for what she believes in.
I call it a...
I call it Ratty. Looks like they might have stumbled out of a 90s rave.
I call it Fancy.
I didn't find the one I want or how to be funny.
Assuming. How to get out the cuddling stage? Maybe just be like, hey, do you wanna like get married or something? And they might be like, absolutely not, and then you're out of it. So like, see you later, never talking to you again, never talking to you. Oh, a sausage dog! Hello, darling. Thank you so much. It says Alfie, which is the name of my dog. Okay. Does anybody have a story they can tell me? Because I really want somebody to talk to me. I thought I could talk to girls, but I was the other woman. Listen, I need to know this. So, tell me the story of your life. What is your name?
This girl started work recently, thought she was quite fit, thought kind of like you'd be going. Ended up going back to her house, you know, had some vibe.
Fun.
Yeah. And then got a week like message from her like this Saturday, going like, I think I see this more of a friend thing.
Friend zone?
Instagram DM.
Instagram DM? Never took
It's alright, and then I find out from another programmer that she's actually written off with something that was very recently. The timelines overlap.
The timelines overlap. The timelines. You are the other woman. Scandalous. Bloody scandalous. You know what? Brilliant story, because that perfectly segues me into my next song. This is a new one that most of you probably don't know, unless you're in my broadcast challenge, because I leaked it in there when I was wine drunk. I wrote this song for a friend of mine, well basically my friend of mine's ex-girlfriend, who got into a relationship with someone else, and there was maybe a slight overlap. And I was like, the ex-girlfriend needs a song. So here you go. It's called Your Next Forever, and it's quite brutal, but it's fine.
It was only last week, you and I were living in a farm tree. 3 years deep, to civilized birds, I couldn't get my own things. I'm going crazy, I never knew. I love to learn how to live without me. And now we're starting again, because I want to. Here it is again. Go on, Michael, restart the bloody track, will you? So this is a nice new song for you. And it's only last week that you and I were living in front of me. In case you didn't get it before, okay? 3 years deep to civilize words when I couldn't get my own pace. I'm going crazy, I would never know that I'd have to learn how to let me go. It was only last week.
Down.
I've always been the curious type. If I wanna get to know you, so you know I know you well. You got your.
Thank you.
in heaven because you're here. And that one says you're our home. That one says you're so loved. I say, shut up, you'll make me cry! Wow. Well, that was already really emotional, so let's just make it more emotional now. My mum and dad are here tonight. I had doing all of this stuff when I was like 13. Dad used to drive me around in the car. He was my roadie. And they used to come and watch me at all the gigs in front of like four bald men in a pub. You're not four bald men in a pub, you're all of heaven! And basically, it's only really been the last couple of years that I've started to sort of feel a bit of, I don't know, you sort of do little rises and then you go, oh, no, it's not. And then you go, no, it's not. And it's kind of always just there. And then this last year has been pretty mental for the amount of people that, you know, have found me, I guess, you weirdos. I wrote this song and it's kind of ironic to sing it now because I wrote this when I turned 25 and that's, you know, the age, isn't it? You know, I'm 25 now, I'm so old. And for my whole life I've been going, you know, I'm going to make it being mum and dad. I'm going to make it mum and dad, I'm not doing anything else. Don't make me go to uni. I'm going to be a pop star. And for ages I was like, it's not happening. And then I wrote this song called What If I Never Make It? And it's really special to me and I wanted to sing it to you guys. If you have a phone torch, now's the moment, Bethel.
Told my dad that I'm scared of failing. He said, will it break your heart if you don't make it? Cause I can get what I want. If only I knew what that was. If every dream that I live is just something I did, how do I know what happened? It's like I'm doing what I know, like I know I'm right. I'm waiting for my phone light to show me I'm light. I'm only 25, fighting for my life, trying to stay alive. They can say you got it, they can say don't give up, but what if I, what if I, make it. I can take the bruises, hold the weight of it all. What if I, what if I, what if I never make it? Yeah. It's stupid and I'm scared of dying, but I don't wanna get to another should have been. It's like I'm scared of letting go, like I'm gonna hold tight on every little I find. My mind finds I'm only 25, fighting for my life, trying to stay alive. I'm just trying to stay alive.
All you wanted when it was my heart. You're always making me fight it. You need a lie from me. Tell me you die for me. We can be promised. If you were promised, I would be crazy. If you need a lie from me.
a bit lower, just a little tiny bit. Yeah? Psycho. Totally mental, it's just so funny, so sensitive, so unpredictable, I'm about to handle. Over emotional, come on, keep those squats going. And all of a sudden, I'm pushing your buttons for no other reason.
My name's Aspen. This
Page.
Aspen and Page.
We met on the Telegram group chat.
You met on my Telegram group chat! Right, wait, let me just stand up here so I can talk to the world. So just to explain to you all, sorry, standing right up. So I've set up some group chats for these shows so the people who are coming on their own could join it and make friends. But you made more than friends, apparently.
Yeah.
So you met in the group chat.
Flirting.
A lot. In the group chat, apparently I haven't seen that, but whatever.
And then I can't remember how we came to talk about it. Paige wasn't even in the chat at the time. And then we were just talking about planning a wedding.
The quiz moved fast, guys. The quiz moved fast. Okay.
And then we've made a tangled themed, and I drew the things.
So you want me to get you married? This seems fast, guys, but I guess I could probably do that. I mean, I have literally no qualifications. I'm just a girl with pink hair and small boobs. Renee Rapp, she's got big tits and a big heart. I've got small tits and pink hair. Okay, so shall I just put rings on your fingers? Is that what the plan is? Please, may I give you my microphone?
She dropped it.
I dropped the bloody ring! I found it. It's because I've got really sweaty hands. Right. What? Put it back. Oh, it's their ring. It's not mine. Don't worry. I've got my ring safe. Right, are we ready? Who's first? Put your finger in the sky and I'll put a ring on it. Wow! Ring number one. Do the thing on the drum. Boom, boom, boom. See? That makes it official. Ring number two, we're ready. Merry wedding day! Happy birthday, Maya! Happy birthday, not official, I love you guys. Also,
I did my nails, like your hair, shoelaces.
Thanks! I love you, and I love your shoelaces, and I love you, and I love you, and they're so pretty. I love you. Thank you so much. I'm so glad I got to do that.
Bye.
Play.
crazy, cause I think I forgot how to drink. I don't know how to flirt in real life, cause I never took it for the land.
Boys and the girls who think